nerds and nerdettes and wee little nerdlings all. It's your buddy Big John and G, the Two Gun Fixit presents Legendary Gaming. Cryptozoic Entertainment. This is a company that took me by surprise a few years ago. I really didn't know much about them about 5 years ago, and suddenly they seem to be everywhere to my perspective. Now that I know of them, and I've encountered their games, and I've enjoyed many of their games, it's easier for me to take notice. And I'm hoping that that kind of rubs off a little bit with you. And with the more attention that you will be able to give it, if you know about it a little bit more. And that's actually the whole purpose of this entire series, really, is for me to inform you about a gaming company that you might not be aware of, and this way you could possibly find something you didn't know exist that you absolutely love. Now, I can't easily go into all the games that Cryptozoic Entertainment has published and is continuing to publish, because this video would last way too long. And quite honestly, this is a labor of love. They're not paying me. Nobody I give a shout out to pays me to do it. So we'll just cut to the chase, and I'll talk about the games that I've played by them and I own of theirs that I think have impressed me. And then I'll mention some games that I know are on my radar from this company that I have not had the luck to buy or acquire at this point. Now, the first game that I recall by this company that took me by surprise, or grabbed me by the throat, actually, and that was Epic Spell Wars of the Battle Wizards. Yeah, it's a bit of a handful, that title. That's a mouthful, I mean. And that's only the general title. There's four now in the specific series, and there's a shoot-off game that has one with a second one coming down the pipes, or it's already out now. So the series has definitely grown, and that is a sign of its success. But what really caught my attention for this game, I have to admit, is a little bit of the grade school humor in these cards, while at the same time this game having a slightly adult feel to it. The mix of it just really makes me laugh. And that's what I love so much about this game, is not only am I gonna walk away from the game, win or lose, feeling like I had a good time at the table, but the game makes me laugh. The spells that you create in this three-part system, or up to a maximum of three-part system, is really adultly, in a grade school manner style, funny. And it always does a great job to catch my attention in this series. And no, I don't have the whole collection of the series. Maybe that was what the Freudian slip there was. I only got the first two games in it, but the first two were really fun. I look forward to getting the rest. Now, some other games that this company has come out with that I've gotten my hands on, either through buying or as gifts, gift certificates, are two games tied to an IP that I've loved since it was introduced in the 80s, and that's Ghostbusters the Board Game, and Ghostbusters the Board Game 2. And both of these pay homage to the movie, but more directly they pay homage to the cartoon series, as well as the comic books that have been published over the years. But the movies are obviously extremely represented in it, since they were in those other works as well. But yeah, expect everything to have a look like the old cartoon series. And that's not bad. I'm not pointing that out as a bad thing. I'm just giving you some information so you can... I don't know why I'm trying to describe it to you when I've already been throwing pictures up. That's so silly of me. But maybe you're listening to this and you can't see this, so you enjoy hearing me try to give some descriptions to these things. Now, the games are really kind of, I find them to be almost like a stripped down, simplified version of Arkham Horror, because you're going around and you got to try to close these portals and these gates while dispatching the ghosts. So there is a familiarity there. You get to see how similar a little bit of the style is. But like I said, if it's anything at all like Arkham Horror, then it's a stripped down and revamped version of it. But you can see the seeds somewhere in those games, and they're really fun games. If you're a fan of Ghostbusters, you're gonna want to check those out by Cryptozoic Entertainment. Now, if you want to really go old school Gen X style and kind of fun with Cryptozoic Entertainment, you're probably not going to do any better than Challenge of the Super Friends. This card game, it doesn't try to emulate the old cartoon show as much as just pay homage to it, if you can follow what I mean with the difference. It's a card-based game, and you're going to relive all those old cartoons. You're going to see scenes and pictures that are just going to rip through your memories and just focus on what you saw decades ago. It's going to bring that all back to your memory. But it doesn't do a great job. Don't expect it to make you feel like it's almost like an RPG-style kind of board game, card game thing. It isn't. But it's still a lot of fun to play with these superheroes and the Legion of Doom and just relive the classic cartoon through the card game. Now, that isn't those aren't Ghostbusters and Challenge of the Super Friends. Those aren't the only cartoon IPs that Cryptozoic Entertainment has and uses, because they also have a really fun dice game, which is based on Batman the Animated Series. And they did this in cooperation with Steve Jackson Games. And I had a lot of fun. It's basically a revamping of the zombie dice game. But now, instead of playing zombies, you get to play one of Batman's enemies, someone from his rogues gallery. And each of the four of them have their own different way that they can kind of bend the rules a little bit and do their own special thing. And that's the big difference and takeaway between this and Zombie Dice. But otherwise, it uses pretty much the same engine to run everything. And it's a really fun game. Now, to move on to games of theirs that I haven't had the opportunity to play, I don't own, I haven't gotten my hands on yet, but I'm really looking forward to it. And the first three, I gotta say, are part of a collection, and I hope there's more. I haven't even played one of these, and I'm already hoping there's more. What does that tell you? No, don't answer that. Oh, go ahead, answer in the comments. I don't care. No, but this is part of what they call the Steven Rhodes Collection. And these games poke fun at the old 1950s style of information books for children, and like Let's Summon Demons, or Don't Talk to Strangers, and Let's Dig Up Treasure. And the art style and everything is definitely poking fun at those old 1940s, 1950s, even into the early 60s style of educational books, basically teaching children not to do things, like don't talk to strangers. And this takes some really fun angles at all of that, from, summoning demons, digging up the dead, and avoiding aliens. So I'm really interested in getting these three, this collection, and trying them and showcasing them all to you. So please go check out those games. They sound a little silly, but I think that's part of the tongue-in-cheek allure of them. So check out more information on the Steven Rhodes Collection of Games. But that isn't it. Those aren't the only ones. There's also a series that they have, and there's a bunch of things in this series, called Spyfall, which is at its base a deduction game, a social deduction game, where you're trying to figure out who's the spy. In a nutshell, that's what the game is about. And I do. I really like the social deduction games. They can be quite fun. And there's a whole different series. They went out with, the original Spyfall, and then they did a Spyfall time travel game, a version of it called Spyfest. And then they kind of mixed up the IP a little bit and brought in DC Comics. So you had a DC Comics Spyfall. Spyfall. They didn't do DC Spy Fest yet, I think. And then they came out with Spyfall 2, and I think that's it. If it is, that's it. Then it's just that's it for the moment, because this is a series that they really enjoy and is selling well. So that's why they keep advancing this series. Now, I'm not very big on deck building games. I have a few of them in my collection. I play them, I showcase a few of them. But generally speaking, they're not my go-to preference of games. But Cryptozoic Entertainment does have a DC deck building game with a lot of expansions for it that I've had my eye on for a while. And just because of my love of DC, especially the classic stuff, but it's not really classic DC. But it's still, it looks fun as all heck. and I've been dying to try it, and that might be a game if you're a DC Comics fan specifically, or just a comic book fan in general, that's something you might want to look into and check out also by Cryptozoic Entertainment. And finally, and remember, I say finally, but there's a lot more games than I'm just saying here. Please go on their page and check everything out and give yourself some more information on what they do. But for me, one other game that they have on their list of games that I'm really looking forward to is a Wonder Woman 1984 card game. There's not a lot. There's at least one other Wonder Woman game out on the market. There's not a lot of games dedicated to our Themyscira princess, and I've always had an interest for Wonder Woman, going all the way back, of course, to Linda Carter. So whenever I see a Wonder Woman game, and like I said, there's not many of them, I do get interested, and I am interested in this one here. But there are so many other great games by Cryptozoic Entertainment. These are just the ones, like I said, that I've played and enjoyed, especially enough to get into my own collection here, or games by them that I'm eyeballing, that I really want in my collection, but for whatever reason, time, money is just not the right moment right now to get it and showcase it here for everyone. But sooner or later, maybe not all of them, but some of them. But that's it. Please, go check out more games by Cryptozoic Entertainment. I think you're going to find something there that you'll like.